take up how to write a book review. So let's see how to do it. Now pick a book of your choice after reading it cover to cover. Start in this way. You can mention the name of the book, the genre of the book, whether it is a novel, a drama, a short story, tragedy, comedy, satire, whatever it be. Then you can talk about the author, the date of publication, the publishers, the price, both of the hardbound and the paperback editions. Now there are certain points to be considered in step 2. You look at the title. Does the title suggest about the plot? Does it seem like an imposition, something unwanted, artificially put on top of the book just because it seems to be good? Is the title justified? Means after you have read the story, do you feel that the title is just exactly what it should have been? Does it suit the storyline? When you read the story, does it seem that the title could not have been anything else? Look at step 3, the language. Is the language simple or is it difficult? Does it use literary devices like alliterations, assonances, personifications, onomatopoeias? Is it written in standard English or are colloquialisms introduced? You must have a look at the language. That does it use standard English or does it have colloquial expressions in between? Step 4, have a look at the plot. How many plots are there? How many subplots are there? Are they well-constructed plots? Are they connected well or do they seem to be forcefully joined? Now, it is very essential that the plot and the subplot should be carefully intertwined. So, you must comment upon that. Take a look at the characters in step 5. Now, characters may be analyzed as round characters and flat characters. The round characters are basically the hero or the heroine who keep on developing and changing throughout the story, the play, the novel. Flat characters are basically the comedians and the villains who do not change. They remain the same from the beginning to the end. You may also take a second analysis of major and minor characters. So in the major characters, you can put the hero and the heroine, and sometimes the villain is considered to be the major character, or you may classify the villain as the minor character along with the comedians, the friends, neighbors and other characters in the story, the play, the novel. Step 6. Ask yourself a very important question. Is it didactic or not? Does it teach you something? Do you get a moral from the book? Does the book teach you something positive? Is it without a moral? Is it moral, amoral or immoral? Meaning, does it teach you something? If it does, it is moral. If it does not teach you anything good and it does not teach you anything negative also, it is amoral. And whether it is teaching you something wrong, so it's immoral. So examine this this book on these particular words: moral, amoral, immoral. Strengths and weaknesses of the book. What did you like about it? You may talk about the plot, the characters, moral, the language, settings, whatever you liked about the book, you can talk about it. What did you dislike about the book? Suppose there were things you didn't like about the book, you may talk about those two, and those may include again the plot, the characters, the moral, language, settings, whatever. Now, if you have any questions with regard to writing a book review, you can put it in the segment below and I shall answer them. Thank you.